distinguished guests, colleagues, friends of the Navy. It gives me great pleasure to be here to represent all of the men and women of Canada's Navy who serve their country at sea, both in the offshore and far abroad. A nation's capital is known as much for its monuments as for any other great works it creates. And this nation's capital, as befits Canada itself, creates monuments that speak to us on a very human scale. And so it is with the Navy Monument that we will soon see erected here in this most privileged of locations in the National Capital Region. This story of engagement and of growth, of competence and confidence in our ability to make a difference in the world, is one in which all Canadians can take great pride. So I look forward to the day soon when the citizens of Ottawa and visitors to our capital city from elsewhere in Canada and overseas make this place, this monument, a common part of their lives in ordinary acts. Quiet contemplation, a morning run, or a family stroll along the river. Because many will pause to consider what this monument symbolizes. And in those thoughts will bring to mind far distant, storm-tossed ships, and the mostly young men and women from every corner of this country who served them, who sacrificed and gave of their last measure that Canada would be stronger and the world better.
The water being used by the Vice Admiral has been collected by Canadian naval ships and submarines from Canada's three oceans, Atlantic, Pacific, and Arctic, as well as the Gulf of St. Lawrence, the Great Lakes, and an international theater of operations. The water samples reflect the country's domestic maritime interests and the Navy's international operations.